God one more shout of praise. And while you're standing, even those who are giving, you're still in the right position to receive. While you're standing, turn your Bibles to the book of Matthew. We'll get there in just a second. Turn your Bibles to the book of Matthew chapter 9. As we just stated, this is the 15th episode of the healing series. But I am declaring today the healing series will be the healed series, and somebody will go from the healing process to the I'm healed testimony. As you turn your Bibles to the book of Matthew chapter 9, I pray you're praying for the preacher as he is praying for you and over you. You know, I just love the gospel. I love the engagement of God's word.
Yes, Lord.
The healing series, the final edition. In the book of Matthew chapter 9, jump down to verse number 12. I want to open up with an opening question. With an opening question. I'm sorry, you guys can be dismissed. I'm sorry, I heard something in the back of me. You guys, I'm sorry. You can be. Let's go ahead and grab your Bibles and turn it to give God praise for the praise today. It will be in standing position to be released. Amen. Thank God for them and their dedication and sacrifice. Now, as you are in Matthew chapter 9, if you're able to stand, remain standing for the duration of the word. But let me pose a question before we get to the text. And this is just a subtext. It's not the true text for this morning. But my question is simply this. We have stated, oh my, we have seen Jesus healing people and people being healed. We've heard major testimonies of healing, both biblically and currently. So my question this morning is, and it's a very serious question I want to pose to you. Has the church lost her power to heal, or have the people lost their faith to be healed?
All right.
Because if in the Bible, every time I open up the Bible and I see in the sanctuary, the tabernacle, or the synagogue, massive amounts of people being healed, and I don't see massive amount of people being healed today, What has happened?
Come on.
Has the church lost her power, or has the people lost their faith?
My God.
You know, there was a time, and I'm not that old. I don't care what they say. I'm not that
Amen.
Old. There was a time when the church was described as a hospital.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. The church was symbolic of being a spiritual hospital where physical, financial, emotional, mental needs could be met in the church. It was the hospital. But being unfortunately, we have now become known more than being a hospital. Now the church looks more like a hotel and a showroom.
God.
You come to church for a hookup.
Jesus.
You come to church to flaunt what you have accomplished in life. No more hospitals, now we're just a flashy showroom. I wonder if Jesus would come and have a conversation with us in 2016,
come on,
what would he say?
Come on, man.
So I looked in Matthew chapter 9, and I'm sure this is what he would say today. Matthew chapter 9, I'm sure by now you've discovered verse 12 and 13. Jesus, upon hearing this, and let me give you the backdrop of what Jesus was hearing. He was on his way from doing ministry, and Jesus chose to minister to what we call the sinners, the heathens, the people who needed a word. But what amazed me as we get ready to read this text, the church people were frustrated with the amount of time Jesus was spending with the sinners. The people who were sick, the people who were in need, the people who needed help, the church folks were frustrated because Jesus was actually spending time with people who needed him. So this is what the text picks up at. I guess I'm confined to this area right here this morning.
Amen.
Holy Spirit, you do what you do best. On hearing this, Jesus said, it is not the healthy who need a doctor, but the sick.
Come on.
It is not the healthy who need a doctor, but
my God, there's a miracle in this place on today.
See, that was a time
Jesus.
where you would go to church with full confidence that you didn't really care who knew your business, because when you got to church at the hospital, you can be restored, renewed. But now we're so fake.
Come on, man of God.
The sick folks got to act like they healthy.
Come on, man of God.
Because church folks will talk about it on social media.
Let you know,
so no real healing takes place because everybody is fronting like they got it together.
Jesus.
Oh, but Jesus says in verse 13, but go and learn what this means. Go and learn what this means. I desire mercy. Missy, I desire mercy, not sacrifice.
My God.
For I have come to call. I have come not to call the righteous, you holier than thou folks. You folks who called me to pray for you, but you more sanctified than I am. You holy, self-righteous
my
folks.
God.
He said, I didn't call you. I didn't come to call you. But I came for the sinners. Take your seats. Let's work out healing to find out that. So you say, I came for the sinner.
Help me.
I came for the sick.
Jesus.
I came for those who will go and do something. Those who acknowledging their struggles. Those who were admitting that I need Jesus.
Yes.
See, some of us, we're acting like we got it all together and we don't even need Jesus. We come to church to hear about how can I make a dollar. Come to church to preacher, encourage me, make me feel good so I can go to work and do better on my job. But I really don't want to hear about that Jesus stuff. I want you to be a self-motivator. I want you to motivate me to go in and do something great. But I really don't need to hear about that Jesus stuff.
Wow.
I just want to be better. But the problem with that is this. When my car, my automobile, has a problem, I take it to a shop.
Mm-hmm. Come on.
But that shop itself can't fix my car.
No. Come on.
But in that shop, there's this person, this individual called a mechanic who works on my car. But no matter how gifted the mechanic is, Reverend Bell and Reverend Hespeck, the mechanic himself really can't fix my car either.
Come on.
Because the mechanic has to have the right tools.
Mm-hmm.
To operate with. Now he has to be in a shop. And he has to have the right skill set. Plus he must have the right set of tools. But when you put the right set of tools in the mechanic's hand, in the shop, he's able to work on your car and make it new again. Likewise, when I'm sick, Bridget, when I'm sick, I go to the hospital building. But I know the hospital building itself cannot make me feel better. So when folks say, I went to church and nothing happened because you just dropped by the church building.